Christmas, 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 Christmas. Yeah.
I was an interesting child. Lamborghini have released the new Aventador S. A Huracan and 458 Italia collided with one another, and the first two new Ford GTs have been delivered. But to whom? All that and more, coming up right now on This Week in Cars. Hello, 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 car lovers worldwide, and welcome to This Week in Cars. A very happy Christmas to you all. What now, Santa?
Jake, come quick. The planet needs you. I was out shooting hoops, getting in the zone for the big game tonight, and then I came back to the parking lot and realized that my sleigh was missing.
You've got to help me. You must have a fast car, right? You talk about them day in and day out.
Well, this is gonna take a while.
If you have not heard yet, the much-rumored Lamborghini Aventador S was finally unveiled this past week. This revised Lamborghini Aventador gets a series of performance upgrades along with a new look, which is focused on aerodynamic performance. It is a bit faster than the outgoing base model, and should be more engaging to drive too. However, this release does come well after the Aventador SV, which was anticipated to be the pinnacle and end of the Aventador run, similar to how the Murcielago SV ended the Murcielago run with a bang. Although Lamborghini has produced S models in the past, typically the SV line is the ultimate and final iteration of the model with Lamborghinis, but apparently there are no specific guidelines anymore, as the Aventador S has been released well after the SV. In my opinion, it almost feels like they're trying to milk as much money out of the Aventador chain as they can before moving on, but in the end, I do admit that this is a pretty sleek looking car, so I guess I can let it slide this time. At the front, there is a new nose and longer front splitter, and the rear gets a new diffuser, available in black or carbon fiber, and the rims are quite similar to those of the SV. Three single exhaust outlets give a new triangular shaped look to the Aventador S, and an active rear wing is included with three different movable positions. Now this next story is a sight that many car lovers might find distressing to view, the crash between a Ferrari 458 Italia and Lamborghini Huracan. Two of the most desirable Italian supercars both residing in Canada. The accident occurred in Massey Tunnel in Vancouver, Canada, when the driver of the Huracan rear-ended the 458 Italia, damaging the front of the Huracan and the rear of the Ferrari. To be honest, while the damage doesn't look too extensive, although admittedly the Huracan looks to have come off far worse, police say that both the cars may be ridden off. It isn't known exactly what caused the crash, but speed apparently was not a factor for once, but rather inexperience according to police. Both drivers were young men in their 20s, one of which was holding a novice driving license. Luckily, nobody was severely injured as a result of this crash, and the Huracan driver was subsequently charged for following the car in front quite closely. In last week's episode of This Week in Cars, you might remember we talked about how the new Ford GT finally commenced the production phase, and that the very first production car had finally come off the production line. And now, the second Ford GT has finally come off the production line as well, and everybody is anxiously anticipating to see who will be the first two recipients of the brand new Ford GT. Thanks to a news outlet, we now know that Ford Executive Chairman Bill Ford Jr. and CEO Mark Fields will be the first two people on the planet to take delivery of the new Ford GT. The buyer list is 500 names long, and includes celebrities, professional video gamers, and a bunch of anonymous wealthy gearheads, and the two head honchos at Ford managed to beat everybody out. With one of these cars specced in the released heritage blue color, while the other is black with orange stripes, I'd say that the combination of these two car specs gives a great taste of what these cars will look like when specced out in the future once more deliveries take place.
Denied. Raindrops. Drip. Drop top. Drop top. Smoking. I'm cooking the hot.
Tiptoe through the wind. You know, there's some people like majorly judging me, watching me from the shadows over there, but I don't care. Well, I'm Santa Claus! Oh. Yeah, so there are some people majorly judging me over there, but
I don't care, boy. I'm Santa Claus.
Let's go, babe.
Yeah, just keep walking. I see ya. Don't think I don't see ya. Thank you all so much for watching another episode of This Week in Cars, and make sure to tune in again next Sunday for another update on news in the car world. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe for more. Lastly, I'd just like to wish everybody a happy holidays, be safe out there, and just have a great time with your family and friends. This has been Jake, and drive safe.